So you need to be able to figure it out. If the orientation is this way, how are you gonna fly it in an eight or figure of eight? Similar exercises, just different orientation. It makes it challenging. That's why you need to practice that once.
All right, so tomorrow is my practical assessment for my drone certification, or the REPL course. I've managed to pass all my online modules. Thank goodness, I don't even worry about studying them. I managed to power it through over the last couple of weeks, and tomorrow is the final step in order for me to get my certification. All I know, it's gonna be a full day thing. They're probably gonna assess my basic and advanced maneuver skills, and also, how to plan missions, how to sort of set up a flight plan and all those things. So probably things that I've learned in the online module, I'm gonna put into practice along with, those basic and advanced maneuvers, so that they can see and grade how good I am as a drone pilot, something like that. Now, actually have been practicing the basic and advanced maneuvers, sorry. The advanced maneuvers, I wasn't quite sure with how to do some of the things in there. So caught up with my flight instructor and showed me a couple of things, a couple of pointers on how to do the advanced maneuvers. It really comes down to, putting the time and effort to practice, those maneuvers. So I've been practicing pretty much every day, almost every day after work.
Back here in the open field again, so just gonna start practicing some of the maneuvers. There's a lot of things to cover. Get this out of the way. I'm doing it early in the morning. It's 5:10 a.m. now, and yeah, it's a little bit cloudy. Not too bad, the wind, but I'm just gonna be flying in low altitude, so it won't hurt me that much. And yeah, look, let's see what we can get out of today.
Go to an eye level, and you move about 10 meters forward, stop, move 10 meters diagonally to the left, then you stop, move backwards again, 10 meters.
Go to a nearby park and practice, doing the figure of eights, the horizontal or the vertical figure of eights. The points of interest, the reverse points of interest. Challenges, I only have really limited time in my battery, and I really want to maximize my flight practice, trying to squeeze every ounce on every minute of that battery. I need to practice my fingers and my controls, and because sometimes when you just move a little bit, it just hover out. So you really need to have that tight control. One thing I found out is you don't actually look at the camera of your drone. You actually fly with visual line of sight on, depending on the orientation of the drone. Obviously that's gonna change the controls you're in. That's something that's new to me, because I always rely on the screens, right? The iPhone screens to, cause that's where you see your videos. So this one's a little bit different, because I'm actually looking at the actual drone. Depending on the orientation, obviously that would change the movements, and that's where they're gonna grade you at. So time and effort to reorient myself, understand the direction of where the nose is or the tail, and how do I do the horizontal eight. So for example, you can do the horizontal eight when the front or nose is facing at you. But they will also test you if the tail is facing at you, or it's the other way around, then how are you gonna do the figure of eight? And also if it's on sideways, how are you gonna do the figure of eight? So that will really change on how you maneuver with your controls. I got a phone call from my flight instructor. He gave me a rundown of what will happen tomorrow. So my call time is at 7:30 a.m. We'll need to wake up maybe an hour before that, because traveling to that location is about 30 minutes. It's an open area. He did mention they're gonna put some cones in and specific sort of measurements, so that I really need to be very tight when I fly, really, follow the flight path that they're gonna present to me. They told me to bring my drone, so I'm bringing the Mavic 2 Zoom. It's currently charging batteries now. Also, told me to bring in notepads. So I've got packing up my drone, so I use my drone, putting it in there in the bag.
Now I've got everything sorted in there. This is my notepad. My battery's charging, my remote control is charging as well. I actually really like this bag. It fits everything, I fit three batteries. I might do a quick video on how to pack the Mavic 2 Zoom into this Fly More kit bag. Yeah, watch that space. I'll drop the link down below once it's ready.
What else? Yeah, look, I'm trying to get a good night's sleep tonight. I'm really, really excited. However, I'm actually a little bit nervous. And plus, it's a whole day sort of thing. So it starts at 7:30. I think we'll finish at about 3. So I'll be there. I'll be there for at least a good 6-7 hours. Let you know how it goes. Hopefully I pass the practical assessment and I'll keep you all posted. Just a quick reminder, if you're planning to get a drone license or become a drone pilot here in Australia, I've enrolled in a repl course. It consists of two exams, one theoretical and one practical assessment. I've done the theoretical already and this is all the practical assessment. So that's really it. Thank you so much for watching. Oh, before I forget, appreciate for all my subscribers out there. Thank you so much. We've hit 500 subscribers. Thank you so much. Thank you for joining the Chua family. And I'll definitely have something in store for you all. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your support. I am very, very grateful, ever grateful. So wish me luck for my exam tomorrow and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.